So we are going to discuss the advantages of thermal power plant and disadvantages of thermal power plant. Then again, we will be discussing some more things about it. So let's come to the advantages of thermal power plant. Number one, the fuel or coal is quite cheap as compared to the nuclear fuel, as compared to the diesel fuel. So this is the advantage, that fuel in thermal power plant is very cheap. And second point is the less initial cost is obtained by the thermal power plant is having less initial cost as compared to other generating station. Like we have already discussed, the hydroelectric power plant needs a huge amount of land, and the nuclear power plant again needs a place where, which is far separated from the population, and the construction of the hydro power plant and nuclear power plant is very costly. Hydro power plant, you have to use the infrastructure of large dam you have to construct, then we have to for reservoir we need to make it so many land, so much land we have to save as the reservoir, and for that we have to shift the villages also. So the initial cost of in terms of land, in terms of construction, it is huge in hydropower plant. Then maintenance cost is less again, but we are talking about the initial cost, the coal steam power plant, nuclear power plant is also costly, and it is costly, and it needs lots of protection equipments. It needs lots of protection equipments for the proper working of it, as we know that a nuclear fuel is very hazardous, very dangerous. So the nuclear power plant construction takes much precautions and much safety, security, and much cost. So thermal power plant is less costlier as compared to nuclear and hydro. That is the reason why the thermal power plant is has the majority stakes in electricity generation, right? Like I have discussed the world energy scenario in the very few classes of unit 1. So we have seen that nuclear fuels very dangerous, but coal, due to its advantages, it is abundance, and 50% of stake of electricity comes from the thermal power plants in India and in the world as well. So the thermal power plant can be installed at any place irrespective of the existence of the coal, but coal can the thing should be considered, like the coal can be transported to the site of the plant by rail or road. So rail transportation or road transportation should be available for transporting the coal or fuel from coal mines, right, from the coal mines to the thermal power plant. This is the thing. So this is the main criteria which we need to consider while establishing a thermal power plant. Otherwise it is okay, we can establish it anywhere, because it doesn't need much construction, and it doesn't need much land. So it is easy to install it. For hydro, for nuclear, you need to you have many criteria for site selection, but for thermal there is no such criteria, and it requires less space, as I have already covered, as compared to the hydroelectric power. Okay. So lastly, the cost of generation is lesser than that of diesel power station. As we know, the fuel is less costlier as compared to the diesel, so the cost of generation is also less. That is the reason that coal or thermal power plant or steam generating power plant holds the majority stakes of the electricity, total electricity generation in India as well as in world. Then there are few disadvantages, but these disadvantages are very, very prominent. The number one is that it pollutes the atmosphere due to the production of large amount of smoke and fumes. Then it is costlier in running cost as compared to the hydroelectric power plant. These two are the main things. It is costlier in running cost, because we have the coal handling should be there, coal transportation is there, so maintenance cost mein hi aata hai, running cost jo hai. Maintenance cost also running is considered to be the running cost, with transportation cost also included in the running cost, because we keep on feeding the coal to the furnaces and the electricity is generated, so coal is required. So the running cost and transportation cost is, you know, it is high. In nuclear it doesn't happen, in hydro it doesn't happen, water is stored, only we have to transfer it from the reservoir to the penstock through the turbine. But and in nuclear power also, we have once we have purchased the nuclear fuel, then a small amount of nuclear few grams of nuclear fuel creates huge amount of electricity. So transportation of fuel need not to be there considered while considering, but in coal we have to choose very particularly, and that the running cost is very very high, because we need to handle it, we need to process it, we need to, and then again when coal burns, ash produced, few gases produced, so we need to take care of that also. For the there are assemblies, there are arrangements for the these things too. So this is the thing which is which is considered as costlier. And the main disadvantage is this. This is the main disadvantage of you know this. Just a minute. Yeah, this is the main disadvantage, that it pollutes the atmosphere due to production of large amount of smoke and fumes. As I have already discussed, people which are residing nearby Korba or Shahdol in Madhya Pradesh, they have lots of suffering from asthma. Very chronic patients of asthma are there, because the smoke and fumes which are there are coal mines in that area. In Korba and Shahdol there are thermal power plants, and coal mines are also there, and power plants are also there. So the flue gases and smoke and fumes are there in the precipitation of the air, and it some studies I have gone through. So it has been seen that the dissolved coal, the dissolved ash, the flue gases particles are there in their water also, right? So groundwater also contains this this contamination, and air is already polluted. If you can see the data. So the people there has more frequency of having asthma. This is a very fact. So you should see that air pollution is the biggest pollution. We were discussing about energy sustainability, and I have shown you the Delhi fog scene of you know that from this year there was in news that crackers after Diwali the pollution raised to the highest level in Delhi in last 4-5 decades. So it is polluting, yes, it indeed polluting the environment. So this is the major disadvantage, which is more prominent than all the other advantages. That is why the government, the world, the people, they from environment activists, they are opposing to put up, or they are opposing for the, you know, increased demand of thermal power plant. They just try to replace it. They are just focusing to replace it, demanding to replace it through the thermal and solar power plant. And this is the fact that coal is only remaining for around 60-65 years. Coal has been remaining only the demand, which is currently we are having the electricity demand. The total installation cost of the existing system and the total consumption which is existing, if we'll calculate by this thing, and if we'll have a population growth, if we consider the current population growth rate, and accordingly if we calculate, people calculated the energy demands in next 60-65 years, so after calculation it was observed that only the 60 to 65 years of coal is remaining. That is it. After 65 years, the coal will be depleted. So we'll not be going to, we cannot use the thermal power plants for producing the electricity. That is why environmentalists, the people, the electrical engineers, the mechanical engineers, the researchers, the energy people, they are talking about replacing the thermal power plants with the solar power plant. At least not to install too much power plants, and to reduce the capacity by producing producing electricity through thermal. So solar and wind power plant is the key thing which can replace this energy, and it is renewable, so it doesn't harm the environment. But there have the challenges too, so we'll be discussing it in the next few lectures.